Welcome back to our ongoing coverage of the disastrous situation in West Texas right now. A fertilizer plant exploding last night about 8 o'clock. Hundreds injured. There are fatalities. We don't know that number. We are worried about that number. We'll find out more as the morning progresses. I want to show you a few headlines that are coming out this morning. This is from the Waco Tribune Herald. Fertilizer plant explosion there. Rocks west. Injuries mount. Waco is 20 miles from West. West is a small town. And Waco, just as much as West right now, is really in the thick of it because this is where all the hospitals are. This is where at least 100 injured are being treated as we speak.
That's right. The Houston Chronicle also sharing with us their headline that you'll be seeing as you wake up. This one says, fiery explosion rocks small town near Waco. When we talk about West Texas and how small it really is, one funeral home, God knows how many funerals are going to be having to deal with. One stretch, which is considered the main drag, a railroad runs through it as well. So we're not talking about a whole lot of people, 2,800 people in this town, and more than 100 of them injured.
Last quick shot here, and this is from the paper in Dallas, and talk about small town, you can see it right here.
There it is.
You can see the diner. You can see the mushroom cloud. 2.1 on the Richter scale, this explosion, wow, by the way, folks. That's how powerful it was.
And some of the things that we haven't gotten to this morning that's also very important, reported by the Dallas Morning News, actually, is the fact that this fertilizer plant, which exploded, apparently had reported to the EPA, the Environmental Protection Agency, and to the local public safety officials that it presented, listen to this, no risk of fire or explosion. That's according to some of the documents that are available. The worst possible scenario, according to the plan, is a 10-minute release of ammonia gas that would kill or injure no one. So when we talk about worst case scenario.
Yeah, and because the situation is developing and so many people are being treated and it's really about survival and getting people well and getting people safe, nobody's really talked about what caused this, and we just don't know. Nobody's even going there yet. But when you talk about the facility saying that they were in good shape, accidents do happen. Was this an accident? Was it more than an accident? We don't know yet.
That's right. We don't know if it's connected to any of the other big headlines that have been happening throughout the week as well, the twin bombings in Boston, as well as the mailings of rice into the federal officials in the White House. And so right now, obviously, we can't say it's connected at all. But an important note, an important date to remember, Friday, April 19th, is the 18-year anniversary of the Oklahoma City bombing. And if we all remember, the Oklahoma City bombing was a truck full of fertilizer that
was. And it's also by Waco, Texas, 20 miles away, where, of course, the Branch Davidian thing happened this week back in the 90s.
We'll be right back with more.